I've been talking to two realtors in town who've lined up some properties for me to go see.
Hey, how you doing? How are you?
Hey,
good.
Good.
How are you?
How's it going?
I'm doing good. How are you doing,
good.
Young man?
I've been doing research in this area, and I want to find a house for about $30,000 or $40,000 that needs mostly cosmetic work that I can do for probably around $10,000, and then flip it for about $80,000 or $90,000, which is the going rate in this neighborhood. This would give me a profit of around $40,000, which is my goal for my startup money.
This is a 4-bedroom. Like I said, it's in pretty decent shape. It was being lived in up to about a month ago.
Nice fireplace, nice build-ins, remove the carpet.
Yeah, I could see this having some potential.
Yeah.
It's not bad. They got a nice alarm system in here.
Yeah.
I like it a lot more than the other two. I like this house, it's in good shape. And they're asking about 40?
49.9.
Yeah, they're asking 49.9.
It needs some cosmetic work, but ultimately, it's not a complete starter house. Fix the floor a little and then do some facelift work, and I think it should look like a brand new house. If I can get in for under the asking price and flip the house for $85,000 to $90,000, I can make my goal for the startup funds. I'd like to make an offer on the house. I'll go in at $45,000.
Resale. What do you think he's gonna get for that?
I think 80.
Yeah, well, I'm hoping to do better than 80, but we'll see.
Absolutely.
I appreciate it.
Okay, got it.
Thanks,
okay.
Thanks.
All right,
bye-bye.
All right, bye.
I've come so far, and if I can't get this done, then I'm basically out of luck. I mean, I won't be able to get my business up. Everything I have is dependent on this home. Hey.
Hey.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, good. Good to see
you. You too.
Yeah, how's it going?
Good, hey.
There's all different styles of leadership. What I fall under would be called servant leadership. I want my employees to feel I work for them. Tell me, give me feedback. Like, take this house. I want Dawn to feel the ownership of this project. So I put her in charge of that. And I want her to be the one that's really in the lead. It's a nice little fixer-upper. You know?
It is.
I have a renovation budget of $10,000, and I need to get it done in about 15 days.
The timeline is a little bit scary. It's gonna be a challenge.
Did you check to see if there's hardwood under here?
There is.
It is hardwood?
Yeah, that's what this is.
Once we get under here and see what's going on, it would be great to have uniform floor throughout, but preserving the original hardwood would be best practice. Preserving the integrity of the home and the original details, like hardwood floors. I don't like to lay down new floors when, if the originals can be salvaged.
In here, obviously, you know, it looks.
Oh my. Unless we're changing the footprint of the kitchen.
Yeah, I wouldn't think we need to.
I think we can just paint these. Kitchen's awful. I would rip it out completely, but kitchens are also over $10,000 to redo. Yeah. It's really just cosmetic in here, new appliances. So we're not gonna change the footprint of the kitchen. We're just gonna spruce it up a little bit. New flooring, new fixtures, new countertops. We're gonna paint the cabinets, brighten it up in there. And I'm excited. Yeah. It's gonna be beautiful. Len asked me to help him out on some projects he's got going on, and I didn't know I was signing up for this, but I'm really excited about it. This is kind of my passion and my forte and what I do.
All right, I love what I'm hearing, Dawn.
It's a lot of work, a lot needs to be done, but I think where there's a will, there's a way, and it can be done. So I will go home and drink my wine and start putting plans together.
I gave myself 42 days to buy, fix, and sell this house, and 10 days have already passed. I'm giving myself 15 days to renovate the house in order to have time to put it on the market for about a week and sell it with the last 10 days reserved for closing. Then I'll take the profits from the flip and put them right into the barbecue and beer restaurant.
I didn't know we were gonna be matching today.
Oh, no, another one, I know, exactly. Hey, what's up, man? How's it going? Good to see you. So I've gathered some people to help me start with the renovation, and man, did RJ come through. He brought his dad, his friend Dan, and his girlfriend Alicia. RJ also got us a dumpster through his contacts at the city. He did all this on his own, and I'll take it. Every bit of help counts. So thanks for taking the time today. You know, we're really anointing this woman right here, Dawn, to kind of take over. You know, we will do whatever you say, and I'm ready to go, Dawn.
All right, so you guys are all gonna work together upstairs.
Okay.
We want to have all the carpets ripped up and out the window. Literally. We're gonna open that window right down into there. And Glenn and I are gonna work in the kitchen. Let's get going.
Heads up. Ready? Oh boy.
Time is a big thing right now. We're going into the, you know, summer season where houses go on the market and there'll be a lot of listings and we want to be one of them. And we want to be the best house that's available in this neighborhood.
Look out below.
Look at you.
Getting there. The floors are, they look a little sanding.
Little sanding. Fix it right all up.
Pulling up all the carpet, I didn't know what to expect, but seeing floors that can come back to life very easy without a whole lot of money is perfect for the budget, actually. Oh, crap. That doesn't look good. It's just something that I don't know that I like to see. Mold. Is Dawn around?
Yeah?
I want to show you something real quick. Yeah, what do you think of this?
It's either mold or cat pee.
I think we gotta get that checked out. Whole new can of worms opened up. There's mold in the house. We need experts. And I don't know what that's gonna cost. Ugh. I've got myself in a mess. If I could back out of the deal, knowing what I know now, maybe I would have done that, but I can't. I own it. Yeah, that's scary. I am 1 month into this 90-day bet, and I'm getting my ass kicked. All right, we will figure this out. My entire business is riding on flipping this house, and finding mold puts all of this in jeopardy. I mean, I found an amazing team, and they've already been very generous with their time, but I can't tell them what's really happening. I can't tell them I'm under a timeline without really any money. I'm basically stuck, and I don't know how to do this without letting them down. Feels like I'm not gonna make this happen.